Ladies and gentlemen, and our dear chief guest, Dr. Ajay Samalti from Garhwal, Uttarakhand. Let me just begin today's session by apologizing for the fiasco that happened yesterday. It was actually not intentional. Something went wrong. And like I was discussing with Ajay sir, he said, this is the beginning of the new normal in education. So welcome to the webinar on the new normal in education. We are indeed happy that so many of you have joined the Google Meet and as well as the YouTube link. This pandemic was very unexpected, and it is really set to transform higher education. So we see that there's going to be a forced shift from our offline mode of teaching to an online mode of teaching and learning. And will this pandemic, or COVID-19 as we call it, drastically transform the future of higher education? How should we as stakeholders contribute to make sure that there is a smooth transition from the classroom to technology-enabled teaching? And I'm sure we have the best person to tell us about that. And I'm sure that this webinar is going to help us identify the key challenges for students as well as teachers in the present scenario. So we are indeed honored to have with us Dr. Ajay Samalti, who is the University SWAYAM Coordinator and Assistant Professor, Department of Pharmaceutical Sciences, HNB Garhwal University, which is a central university in Garhwal, Uttarakhand. Dr. Samalti, after completing his M.Pharm and MBA and PhD in chemistry and pharmacy, went on to do his postdoctoral fellowship at Meiji University, Japan. He has an academic and research experience of more than 16 years. Dr. Samalti has completed 10 research projects funded by various agencies and successfully developed and run two SWAYAM MOOCs, that is Academic Writing and Industrial Pharmacy 1, with 80 hours of teaching learning materials, including more than 40 hours of video lectures. He has contributed 4 e-modules for ARPIC course of Guru Jambeshwar University of Science and Technology in Haryana. Dr. Samalti has published 74 papers, 6 books, and has 2 patents to his credit. He has presented papers in more than 100 conferences and is a highly cited researcher with an H-index 23. He was awarded the DECO Foundation Postdoctoral Research Fellowship and invited by Meiji University, Japan as a visiting scientist for research. Dr. Samalti was awarded the prestigious National Research Award by the UGC New Delhi and the Young Scientist Award of the Year 2007 by the Uttarakhand Council of Science and Technology. Dr. Samalti is an expert reviewer of the Iceland Research Foundation, Israel Science Foundation, and a scientific expert for the Ministry of Institution and University Research, Italy. He has delivered more than 40 invited lectures and open educational resources, OERs, academic writing, nanoparticle research, research methodology, research ethics, software and research, MOOC, blended or flipped learning, research proposal writing, academic integrity, plagiarism and the like in various training programs in FDPs, human resource development centers and other institutions. Dr. Samalti is a member of the Asian Council of Science Editors, APTI and IPA, and is on the editorial board and also a peer reviewer of various national and international reputed journals. He has supervised 25 M.Pharm research projects. His research interests include cyclodextrin and lipid complexes, small angle neutron scattering, nanoparticles, natural products for drug delivery like obesity and hair loss. It is indeed a great privilege for St. Albert's College Autonomous, the IQSE Center, to have Dr. Samalti to do this webinar for us. On behalf of the IQSE of St. Albert's College Autonomous and all present here, I extend to you, sir, a very, very warm welcome, and over to you, sir, for the webinar.
Thank you, Dr. Nisha. Thanks a lot for the quite long intro, okay? Thanks a lot. So, as I was mentioning that, you know, first of all, there is no need to be feeling sorry and anything for the inconvenience. It is not inconvenience. We have to learn the first lesson that it is the technology. It is not just to erase human. to arrest technology is also the part. Okay. And there is no issue. We should not, you know, worry about these glitches. It will happen. We will have to learn bearing these things, first of all. Okay. You know, and these things happen in our physical classrooms also, but things are always in the four walls. So that's why nobody knows about that. Okay. But when we are open in media, when we are open in social media, when we're open in these platforms, we feel sorry. No need to worry about these things. These are going to be the part and parcel of our life. No issue at all. So first of all, thank you very much for inviting me for the lecture, Dr. Nisha and all the IQC team. I think they were quite busy before, quite, you know, I think for the last entire week. Okay. So however, it needs efforts to organize even a single thing. And especially when we are doing it for very first time, or you can say at the very first platform, it may have some scenarios. It doesn't mean, okay, no need to worry. First of all, before moving to the thing or the topic, before delivering my exact lecture, I would like to clarify that whatever the content I'm delivering is just a part and parcel of our training part and all that. Secondly, so whenever you require any support regarding certification, all that, please contact your organizers. Dr. Nisha is there to help you out. Okay. Thirdly, we'll be moving quickly and have patience with your questions, note it down, but ask when these things are over, because I think I will try to address almost every query of yours. Okay. You can hear me, na? Dr. Nisha, any problem?
No problem, sir. You can hear me.
Okay. If anything is there, you can contact. I have given you the number, alternate number. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So, as far as the normal is concerned, it is looking abnormal in the first instance when we are in the post-COVID-19 scenario. That's why for changing from this from changing to this abnormally normal thing, we need the courage. Some challenge, we will start the thing one by one with my presentation. I will give you a brief presentation. Okay, say I will try to focus more on teaching and little bit on learning, because both are the part and parcel of life. Because it is not you can't say that a teacher is not supposed to learn. Rather, I say that teacher is the greater learner, and he or she needs to put the greater efforts in learning rather than his or her student. I think you will agree with me if you are really you are serious with your profession. Only that. So, teaching and learning, how we can convert our physical classes into our online teaching classes. Okay. And what are the other things? Because it is a very vast topic. You can't say that, you can't expect each and everything in 1 hour from me or from anyone. Okay. All things are there. I'm just giving you an outline that what thing you must know for converting your class, your physical class, into the online class. You know, it needs more efforts. So let's start. I'm shifting to my presentation. Okay. And in any way, we will come back. If you have any query, you can ask at any moment, and your moderators will ask on behalf of you. Okay, Dr. Nisha, please take care. Now moving.
Anji, sir.
So yeah, I'm moving for the presentation. Yeah. Now you can see my screen now. Okay. Is it visible to you?
we have to pin the screen.
Hold on. Just a minute.
Yes, we can see the screen, sir.
Okay. So friends, our topic of this webinar is the new normal in education. Dr. Ajay Semalti, as Dr. Nisha has given the introduction, I'm just moving. No, I'm just giving you the 10 commandments of the new normal in education. On the basis of my experience and what I feel is needed to be learned by either by the teacher or by the student, these 10 commandments you must note it down, and we will focus one by one to each and every component. Okay, so let's take explore, refer, swim. First of all, as we are in India, तो कहना चाहूंगा तो सबसे पहले भारत की बात सुनाऊंगा, ठीक है? बिकॉज द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इज स्पेंडिंग अ ह्यूज मनी, टाइम एंड एफर्ट्स इन डेवलपिंग द थिंग्स एंड यू हैव ईच एंड एवरीथिंग. लेट्स मूव, एक्सप्लोर, रिफर एंड स्वयं. नाउ एज यू नो, स्वयं इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म ऑफ swayam.gov.in. ओके, इट्स अ प्लेटफॉर्म विच एम्फसाइजेस ऑन दिस access equity and quality of education. In our education policy, these three are the cardinal principles. Access, each one must have the access to the education, equal opportunity must be there, and the quality things must be available for the conventional as well as the non-conventional learner. I will talk later in the Swayam in detail, but I would like to clarify one thing, that in Swayam, because most of the people know, take go to the swayam.gov.in for my presentation. Okay, we'll move to this thing, and then how we can get the enrollment and all that, filtering the thing. My single request is that UGC has enabled the credit transfer, the credit mobility towards the courses done through this web. It means in the post-COVID-19 scenario, it is not this year it was declared. Actually, it is with the Swayam from the beginning. You can take one or two course, select which is, you know, just similar to your regular syllabi, and then what you can do, you just take it to your BOS, Academic Council, okay, and get it passed for credit mobility through that MOOC. It means the student will get enrolled from that MOOC only. So these are the MHRD digital learning initiative. You can have a click on this list. And if you'll go to this first link, swayam.gov.in, this is the master link. You will get all the links which I have mentioned here in this link. Okay, swayam.gov.in. And I think 412 courses from NPTEL, which is having the courses for arts, humanities, maths, physics, engineering, biomedical, okay, chemistry, biochemistry, law, and other than that, UG 82 courses and I think PG 42 courses are available there for this cycle. All courses are also available in the offline mode. Okay, UG PG MOOCs, they in the offline mode, all the courses are available, contents are available. What you can do, teachers, and please do note that the teachers will get, even if their students are taking this course from this Swayam, they will get the recognition as a mentor. They can be mentor for their class and get registered as a mentor in that course, and they will get the, you know, certification and recognition as the mentor. One thing, okay. E-content, you can. I will go to one by one later, but just giving you the website. I think you might have taken the snapshot of this thing. However, you will get all the links in the swayam.gov.in. I'm moving back. So what I request, that take at least, if you are from government, either government or the private or the deemed university, select the suitable course which is matching to the syllabi of UG or PG or PPSG course and the relevant credit, you can pass to your body, government to your university authority or syndicate, whatever you call, and the credit transfer may be done through that MOOC only. You need not to go for the physical classes. What you can do, yes, mentor can translate them, or you can say the translation approach to, for reaching to the students may be adopted, and the mentor will help the students in improving the reach and understanding of that particular topic. Okay, so moving back to 10 commandments, first we have done. Okay, I have kept it brief because many people know about this SWAYAM, but I will come back again with the SWAYAM portal at the last. Okay, second is yes, know, refer, share, and learn to share OERs. OERs are open educational resources. Now, you have to learn what are the OER commons. Please note it down, because if we'll go one by one to each and everything, it would be very typical to cover all the things. So just going through the overview. OER commons, you type the OER commons in the Google. Have a snapshot of this thing. OSS, Wikimedia Commons. Wikipedia itself is an open educational resource. Open Courseware, OERU, OpenStax College, Academic Earth, YouTube, SlideShare, Wikipedia, with due care. Please do take care of the thing, because YouTube, SlideShare, and Wikipedia are the, these are the information providers, basically. You will have to select, being a teacher, or being a student, being an academician, you will have to be vigilant for selecting the things which are of quality, standard, and from the original source, and needed, ethical, whatever you call. Okay, and I think you are getting my point. Now, after the point two, I'm moving to the third point, which is very utmost important point. Develop habit of online learning. So this is the habit we will have to adopt. This is the habit. Kya karne ka? Habit change karne ka. Students change the habit on the basis of online learning. Even the teachers, if you are spending your time into the classroom, online classroom, you will have, because everything is going on record. Dear friends, when we are online, हमारे यहाँ नॉर्थ में कहते हैं कि खुल्लम खेल फरुखाबादी, मतलब सब कुछ ओपन है, एवरीथिंग इज ओपन भाई, इन फोर इन द क्लासरूम इन द फोर वॉल्स, कुछ भी आप करते हैं, वट एवर यू डू, इट रिमेन्स देयर इन बिटवीन यू एंड स्टूडेंट, बट व्हेन यू आर ऑनलाइन, व्हेन यू आर गोइंग डूइंग दीज थिंग्स गो ऑन रिकॉर्ड, सो यू विल हैव टू बी वेरी विजिलेंट, एंड द हैबिट. Habit, what I showed, because your body language, your attitude, everything is on record and it must be kept in your mind. The timing is also there. I will come to that particular point, but that habit you will have to inculcate. And this is the high time. Now, moving to time management in online teaching learning. You know, it is very important part. Why we need to manage the time, average engagement time of student of learning in one sitting? Believe me, that you can, if I say that I'm going to address you for 4 hours, will you be able to sit for the 4 hours or even the 2 hours? No. Actually, the average engagement time depends on the brain's concentration power. And in general, you take my words that you cannot concentrate in a particular video which is running before you, and especially when it is educational, you cannot concentrate more, you can't concentrate more than 6 to 7 minutes. Yeah, it is the fact. The studies have shown it. So the challenge is that you will have to manage the time. Data limit of student. I can't say that many people, I also suggest many of the participants that they can, especially who are with us in the Google Meet, they to save their data, they can switch off their camera, no issue. Okay, so it will save your data. And student, remember, you might have the you have a fat salary. Okay, the government has given the free Wi-Fi in their institutions, or your but your student don't have. Okay, so take care of them and limit your class into 30 minutes, 40 minutes, not more than that. Don't go beyond that. Okay, convenient timing. That convenient time is always a unconventional time. It may be 6 to 7 p.m. It may be 8 to 9 p.m. It might not be 10 a.m. to 11 a.m. That conventional timing many times doesn't suit because people work till late night. They generally wake up late in the morning, especially when in the lockdown scenario and when your entire things are going online. And do not compare, always please teach us. Hamari aadat hoti hai, hum logon ka style hota hai yaar, ki we compare the things. Oh, the previous class, the first batch was very good. It is not like that. You cannot compare it with the physical class. You know, every online class is unique class. You must have the capability to go for the power pack presentation. This is utmost important. And you will learn, if you go to the MOOCs, you learn that whatever the topic the teacher or expert is explaining in 30 minutes, many times, if I explain my particular 30 minutes module to my physical class, it will take 1.5 hour time maybe. Because in online, you cannot repeat again and again the same thing. You must present it power pack. The power pack presentation must be there. So moving to the next thing, organizing. What to organize? Because, you know, when you are going the offline, chalega, anything you can go, okay, sir forget his book and then ask Ramesh, please, you bring my book from my chamber. You cannot do like this in online, okay? So, what to organize? The contents. The contents must be organized. It is unlike the physical class. Please do remember, you will have to be very vigilant. You have to organize your time at which point of time, which particular topic require which particular time, and how you will switch from one content to another content. Your student must be organized, okay? UG and PG, different classes you can create. I will come to this point also. Coverage. Don't try to cover each and everything in 15 minutes. No, you must have. For the standard, I will give you that if you go for the 30 minutes video lecture, not more than 30 slides or 40 slides should be there. I have seen the presenters who have the 150 slides, 100, 200 slides and going on blah, 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 blah. You can't do that. And the utmost important thing is tuning it with your daily life. Tune it with the daily life. It is very important because we are not habitual of these things normally. So we will have to tune it with your daily life. And this is actually the new normal. Next thing is, have the learner-centric approach. Explore the engagement. In physical class, you can see the entire body language, the presence and all the things, but in the online learning, you need various efforts for the learner adopting the learner-centric approach. Okay, in the learner-centric approach, you have to adopt lot many strategies. There is no thumb rule. What we can do that. Again, moving to that particular point, learner-centric, I forgot to mention a particular thing. There are no thumb rules. Please do mention. It is not different thing. Actually, you keep on teaching in your natural style, but you need some orchestrations. Okay, you need some strategies to engage the student, to focus on recall, revision, you know, the discussions, activity, assimilation quiz, etc. You know, the ultimate aim is, I think, making it easy. If you try to complicate, it will be very typical for you. The student will run away. What he or she do? She will put off, you know, she will switch off her camera, his camera, voice, and just idle. It will be. It is an idle class you are running, actually, if you try to complicate. It is not the time to show your expertise about the apps and all that. Don't use variety of LMS. Give the clear instructions, FAQs. I'm coming to this point. Before going to the next point, I will like to quit for a while and will talk to you face to face. Yeah, I think you can see me now.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, dikhai de.
So, what I mean to say, you know, it is very easy to show your expertise. But to whom you are showing your expertise? The problem is, this one I want to emphasize, that in showing your expertise or showing your, you know, rapport, what the people are doing nowadays when this, you know, the flood of online learning came, the people don't know the exact expectation of a student. Actually, you know very well, but you want to show your authorities, your seniors, that, sir, I'm doing. People are taking the class in the Zoom for 1 hour, 2 hours. Then again, next sir is ready to grab those kettles to take their class into the Zoom. Again, the students are in the next class. Then another teacher is having the class of the same students at the next hour schedule on the WebEx. Another person is doing on the Google Meet. What you want to do, actually? No, you are individual, but that class is not the capacity is there, na? Student must have that. You will have to plan the things as you plan for physical class. In general, you don't plan more than 2 to 3 classes, theory classes, in a day. But what you are doing in the online learning, actually? Tell me. I think you will agree with me. It is not the run. Actually, when you go for online teaching, though covering the syllabus is very easy, but engagement is very important. And engagement is really the challenge. Even in the education system, especially in the government system, when the people, when a teacher is having it more than 1,500 students class, they don't bother about the things in general. And really, it is not practicable. They can't practice engaging each and everyone. But here, with some efforts, you can have very good engagement and very good interaction, rather than more than the physical one, which is my experience. Because student doesn't have any hesitation to ask any query. He or she can ask any query on the discussion forum. You have made a discussion forum that, come on, you can ask me. You know, I have handled, you know, I have interacted with more than 20,000 learner, 25,000 learner, you can say, from my one course, 2 runs, and second course, 1 run. Both of my courses are again available there. We'll be discussing them later. But what is my takeaway? That it is not the content which make your class successful. Because content, you can take the, you know, any, if you are in Hindi, or if you are in English, you can take the Shakespeare, doesn't matter, content is of Shakespeare. It is the communication, actually. It is the communication, it is the, you know, learner-centric approach, how you can engage your student, how you can enter into the brains of your students, especially when you are having the online interaction mode. So what you can do, it is not needed, Baba, to have face-to-face Zoom meeting with all your students. What you can do, you can record a lecture, deliver them, and just deliver them, and then you can discuss on a WhatsApp group what is going on. You can create a Google group for the discussion. That engagement is important. Seeing faces is not important, believe me. However, you might be needing that for clicking that pic and showing to your authorities. Maybe it may be your motto. But actually, if you really want to convert your physical class to your online class, genuinely, you don't require actually. Actually, you are spending the data and time of the student. So it is easy, but you will have to change your mind. Again, moving to the presentation. So this I wanted to emphasize. That's why I, moving to the, we were on the maximize. Yeah, now after the making it easy, we were, just a minute. Making it easy, we covered. We say that, and don't try to show your expertise. Okay, in having a lot number of LMS, learning management system, give the clear cut instructions, FAQs. You can't expect that your student knows everything about Google Meet. You must have a special FAQs file. Float it first before going to that particular meet. Float it the FAQs about the Zoom before going to that particular meet. Okay, you can't say like that. Okay, you don't know about this thing. How can you do this thing? How can you present? Arey Baba, he doesn't know. She doesn't know. You will have to, you know, give the priming or handling with that particular app. Okay, so it is also the part and parcel of online teaching. Aap kahenge, you will say that okay, I'm a chemistry teacher. How to train them? No, if you are handling with this thing, you must know. Okay. The basic things. So maximizing the use of available resources. Why I'm telling you in this scenario? Because you cannot go for buying a webcam at this moment. Can you go to the market? And even if you go to the market, will you be able to buy that? The availability won't be there. Okay. You can't buy every new software. There are so many software. Will you be able to buy each and every software? What you need to do, you need to utilize. You can't go for, you know, tablet. You heard that, okay, from tablet I can use the tablet style, Khan style. Will you be able to buy a new tablet if you are not having? Okay, you can't. What do you need? That you please explore the uses of your available resources. What you can do from your laptop, what you can do from your mobile, what you can do from desktop. You need to explore that thing. Money can't buy each and everything. Remember this thing. Now moving to the next part, that is learn using common tools and teach the same to students. These tools must be needed. They are in a need of the era. Don't bother about them. Google Drive. You know, there are 9 dots in the Google Gmail when you use. Have you explored that 9 dots? How many apps are there? How many, you know, things are there? Google Classroom, Google Drive, your YouTube and other thing, Google Forms, Google Docs. So many things are there. Please explore them for your teaching and learning. Okay, YouTube. Have you explored YouTube really for teaching and learning? There are so many channels by the universities which provide wonderful and plethora of information and the knowledge, not just information, knowledge. But you need to pick and choose proper thing. Teachers are owed to select the suitable resources for your students. Microsoft Teams, as you might be having the experience of Classroom, Google Classroom, when you go to the Gmail, 9 dots, Google Classroom, you can have an idea that you can create a virtual classroom and invite all your students to a classroom. And I think most of you people are having this experience. Related to that, Microsoft Teams, if you are having the Microsoft IDs, what you can do that you can connect with, you can connect with the Microsoft IDs with your students and the similar to Classroom, but having the more, you know, very wonderful features Teams is having, Microsoft Teams. Especially when you are in government universities, if you are having the government IDs, NIC IDs, it is freely available for government institute. Microsoft Teams is freely available. Okay, like in the, I think Google's, I think in some cases that G Suite is also free. They are providing for the for free maybe. Okay, if I'm not wrong. Okay, Google Group, WhatsApp, Telegram. Dr. Nisha utilized the Telegram. I liked it. I liked her approach in this thing because Telegram, do you know the Telegram groups don't have the member limit, if I'm not wrong. Dr. Nisha, am I right?
Yes, sir, you're right. Yes, sir.
So Telegram is very good for interaction. Okay, for interaction that you don't have the member limit is there. WhatsApp, the member limit is there. Okay, in Google Group also you can create the Google Group. there also you don't have any word limit. We use it in our LMS, in G Suite ID, which we are having as a course coordinator in the SWAM. We have made the platform in the Google group at the discussion forum we have made, and we use it. You can also use it, what you need to do, and also use the Facebook wonderfully. Facebook, even the simple things, what I'm saying is that simple things can be used very smartly. Now moving to last point, that develop and share the need-based e-content OER and MOOCs. Things are many, bahut si cheeze hai, but aapko focus karna padega. You need to focus to your students' need. So you need two things, tools and platforms. Tools, they may be handwritten notes. Many people say, I'm not tech savvy, I don't use laptop. Senior teachers, maybe. I can't expect from the new teachers, and even for who are having the up to 20 years of experience, they are not supposed to tell that they don't know the computers. Okay. Even the handwritten notes, you can scan them and just share in the WhatsApp group. Scan the images, flowcharts, draw them by your hand, share in your groups. You can also make the closed Facebook private groups for your classes, just like WhatsApp group. Don't make it public, make it private, and you can have the interaction. Wonderful tool is there. You can share the videos there in the Facebook even. Using mobile for recording, yes. You can use the mobile. Recently in last webinar, I also addressed this thing. Simple mobile can be used for the recording. We will discuss it. Talking it with webcam, if you are having webcam, that's very wonderful. What I'm doing at this particular time, I'm having the webcam. I'm having a mic. However, I have this orientation for last 2 years. It's not just about the COVID. I have been there in the online teaching and learning for last 2-3 years specifically. And laptops, you can use it very smartly with the use of so many softwares are available. Voiceover you can do for the PPT, and you can share it to platform like SlideShare and all that. We'll discuss Loom, Canvas. You can take the help. Please note them down. Okay, I cannot address each and everything. Please, if you know how to use Loom, go to the Google Baba will let you know. Okay. Recording free softwares like OBS, Camtasia, they are free open source softwares are available. If you are more tech savvy, if you are you know, more than the average knowledge you are having, you can go for these recording softwares. Platforms, you know, various platforms. YouTube, you can have your own channel. Okay, your institution can have a new channel, a separate channel, subject wise channel. SlideShare, OER Commons, LMS like Moodle, okay. Podcast can also be used. I'll be addressing this thing also in my presentation, that again, when we'll be discussing some courses. Podcasts are just like the video channel, they are the audio channels. So Anchor, SoundCloud, so many things are, so many freely available podcasts are available. You can have podcast mein karne ka kya hai? You just record your voice and upload it. You don't require anything, Baba. You just require your mobile phone, record your voice, and just upload it to that particular app, and it will be available just like YouTube to media. You can and you can share it. You can record the lecture and share to your student. It is useful at least for many subjects in which you don't require, you know, equations and other things, so many technical things. Okay. So before moving to our courses, I'll just have two things, then we will discuss, you know, academic writing. We have recently launched, yesterday itself, we have launched the next cycle of academic writing, and we have been top 30 courses. You know, we have been in the top 30 courses worldwide and declared by the MHRD and the Press Information Bureau. You can go to the SWAM and enroll in academic writing. Yes, as far as the academic writing, it lets you know about the things. I'm not here to, you know, advertise the thing, because SWAM is free platform. There is no commercial exploration of this platform. So you please explore. Okay, I won't tell anything. Our course will tell a lot of things. So industrial pharmacy is pharmacy subjects first MOOC of country, which is also open for enrollment. We have covered 7 semesters industrial pharmacy paper entirely in the 12-week course module with the industrial aspects, live domains. You can just go there, enroll them, then we will be starting the course. Meanwhile, we also perform a lot many things. Industrial pharmacy, we are the pioneer in pharmacy with the first MOOC for B-Pharm students. We are also for those teachers, researchers, industry personnel. We will address this thing later, LCM application. Now we will just talk face to face for a while. I think it's 2:41. So what I'll see that so let me chaliye hum isi ko baat kar lete hain fir ek saath aapse questions lete hain theek hai. I'm just in 5 minutes, 7 minutes I'll be finishing my discussion. Okay, 5 minutes, then we will be opening the session for the discussion. अभी भी आप स्क्रीन ही देख रहे हैं ना मेरी?
Yes, we can see you, sir.
Okay, I'll see me or my screen?
We can see you.
Okay.
Your screen? Should I pin your screen?
इधर रुको, मैं करता हूँ. I'll do. Hey, stop sharing. Okay. Yeah, you can see my screen ना? दिख रहा है मेरे
screen?
आप दिख रहे हैं? है ना? हाँ, LCM application, right? Okay. So LCM is learner centric MOOCs. देखिए, when we go for the SWAM, देखिए SWAM का आपका जाता है, ये हमारा पिछले कोर्स का शेड्यूल है. In this schedule, you will find the introductory video, the lineup है, the announcements are there. You get the announcement properly. ये this is about each and every course, the standard things. Announcement you will get. Whenever the week, whenever the course coordinator want to get the any information about the course, he or she will give you the email, which will also be available in the announcement part about the course. This is the detail of the course. Ask a question whenever the session is going on. You can poke any question. You can raise your query, and it will be directed to the your discussion forum. So actually, it is a discussion forum. What is? Ask a question. Ask a question section is a discussion forum which takes you to the Google group. Progress, whatever the quiz marks are there, scoring is available in the progress section, and how you, whether you have studied or not. Mentor, what I told you, most of you are faculty member. If your subject is there in your, in the SWAM, go to the SWAM, select your subject which is in the syllabi, and you can play the role of mentor. You also get enrolled in that course. And you will be recognized as a mentor along with your students. Your students will be there, and you will be the mentor of your student. Though your student as well as you, you will be there as a learner. But you will come to know what the things are going on there, and you also do the course. So in this way, you can do the blending. Whatever the the video is there, you can also explain them. So it's the blending of the course staff, the TAs, all that. So it means we had the more than 20,000 enrollment. What we applied, we did the pre-survey. I think many of you, please go there. Whenever you will enroll, you will get a confirmation email. First of all, a personalized mail will be there. Then the pre-activity, we will be asking the thing. However, in the last cycle, we did a live webinar before the start of thing, and we have done a lot many webinars live, and we discuss that what you need before the launch of the course, plagiarism, etc. Many things we discussed. Live interaction and webinars. I think more than 20 webinars we have done for the last 2 cycles. We have the YouTube channel with more than, I think, 2,000 subscribers, maybe at this particular time. And we have made the all webinar publics and for the course. Learning by doing, activities we have given. Actually, in your class also, you will have to give some activities. Give some homework, brief homework. Don't give a homework which requires lot many efforts. Give them tricky things so that you can come to know whether the student has gone through the thing or not. It is not about digging a, you know, well. Okay, don't give that kind of exercise. Give simple exercise to just to assess. So discussion forum, you will have to be very vigilant. This extension trajectory, it is LXT basically. We gave more than, you know, 20 to 30 extra videos of from the expert, like from Professor Sahana Murthy's videos. We gave with the along with these our own groups. we have the Facebook group for industrial pharmacy and the academic writing both. You can join us also there. So you will see the engagement we have provided with the, those. We have more than 10,000 group members in academic writing and more than 3,000 to 4,000, I think, in the industrial pharmacy. So, and yes, this is the podcast. Please note bit.do/AW podcast semulti. AW podcast semulti. Okay. So AW podcast semulti, if you click, you will come to know what we have done. However, there, what I felt, what was the need that in the Kashmir, our students were feeling the difficulty, especially with respect to seeing the 3G videos, in 4G speed, or they were not getting the speed. So what I did, I recorded my things, my message, my concluding message, and just uploaded into that podcast, Academic Writing. Then you can listen it just like radio, and it won't require a few MB, a few MB, not GBs. Okay. So by this way, you can do, especially arts and humanity people can do these things. So this is our team, my better half, Dr. Mona Semulti, and my colleague, and Dr. Professor Rajat Agrawal from IIT Roorkee. These are our experts, Professor MSM Rawat, Honorable Vice Chancellor, former Vice Chancellor of our university, and currently Advisor Higher Education, Government of Uttarakhand. And this is Professor Joseph from Kerala, from Central Institute of Kerala, who is our academic academic reviewer, Professor D.S. Rawat from University of Delhi. So we have Pan India team. He's my project associate, Lokesh, Pandava's Creations, our team. And this was all about the PG MOOC. Now coming to the Industrial Pharmacy MOOC, we have more than 2,000 learners. We created a character journey, gave the live demonstrations of our instruments. You know what you can do if you are going to your lab, you just record how a particular instrument functions and just record it. So it is my university, Hemanti Nandan Bahuguna, Gadwal Vishwavidyalaya, near the bank of river Alaknanda, and from my place it is 200 kilometer Badrinath Shrine, and you can say the China border. Okay. So our central university, I formally thank my mentors, my UGC, CEC, MRC Roorkee. Okay, I am Bangalore and NITR Chennai. Who dares to teach must never cease to learn. Please do take care of these things. Aapko himmat to karni padegi. This is typical task to teach. We are framing the generation. Okay. So this is, you can take the pick and we can take the questions. Meanwhile, the new normal in education, I finish it. You can go to my YouTube channel. Okay, the Open Knowledge Semulti, you write. You will get my open channel. If you are getting it, you can see that thing. We have the Swayam HNBGU. And please go to the site also, swayamhnbgu.in. We have created a repository also, subject repository. Our all the faculty members have contributed, and it is a huge repository of subject wise, and you can student can filter. You can also enjoy this. You can also avail this facility from the suggested and created repository. Okay. Facebook group, we have the two effects, Facebook group, Academic Writing, Industrial Pharmacy. This is my email ID and my phone number. So this is all from my side, and Dr. Nisha, it's over to you for taking up the questions, and you please carry on. And I'm leaving for a while this slide for record, and then meanwhile you can carry on. Dr. Nisha, over to you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for that very thought-provoking session. It was really wonderful. Now I think we can take questions. If you have any questions, I think the participants can post it on the chat box. Rather than unmuting and speaking, you can post it on the chat box. We'll take the questions.
Dr. Nisha, I have shared, I think, first slide and last slide. Okay, snap to you. You can share all the participants in the email along with your certificates. Okay.
Yes, I'll do that.
I'm quitting this presentation.
Okay, there's one question, sir.
Please carry on.
weightage given to online learning certification on the real ground of education? How much weightage can be given to online learning certification on the real ground of education? That's one question from Mrs. Annie Jessica, I think. Can you see the question, sir?
I couldn't hear you properly. Please repeat your question.
How much weightage can be given to online? One second.
Online versus offline?
Online learning. How much weightage can be given to online learning certification?
That's why I have very firstly, I have asked about the SWAM. Because SWAM has got the weightage of 4 credits and RPET courses, your career for your credit advancement schemes, they are valid. But as far as the weightage of an online certification is concerned, you know, when you are going for online for entirely for each and everything, then there is no question. Each and everything is valid. Okay, until it is at a reliable platform. Okay. No Tom, Dick and Harry can open up his or her shop and sell the things. You will have to be very vigilant, okay, for getting those. Don't run behind the certification, all the things. Run behind learning the things. Learning is at most important. If you learn the things, go and implement that thing, okay. Certification, you are asking a question. You know, UGC has given 100 big universities for running the online degree programs. You know, they are coming up with the 100 online degree program. And I think UGC has started giving more than 40% of credits can be transferred through the SWAM MOOCs. It means almost 50%, you can say, 50% of your papers can be taken from the SWAM. Online, they can be taught. So this is the era. You can't say anything that that it is not valid. It is not valid. Though be vigilant that you will have to be, you know, forgery and all that cases, that kind of thing. You will have to be very vigilant about this. Yes.
Okay, so next question. The next question is, sir, can you please suggest a way how to use online teaching for practicals in science subjects and how to conduct internals for the labs?
Yes. First thing is blended learning. You will have to adopt the blended learning. First thing, that teachers, please go to YouTube. Please go to YouTube and search the video which is, you know, explaining the things. I think you might have tried that thing. And many times I also found it very difficult to get a particular video which caters the demand of that practical thing. If not, what you can do, you can, at least teachers are going in many places. What you can do, if person is going, you can do that particular practical or related thing, or at least you can also explore these simulation softwares. In many things, in chemistry, in physics, there are simulation softwares are available. Okay, please explore them. You will have to be very tech savvy if you want to explore the thing. And you can at least give the protocol written step by step to each and every student that yes, it is done like this. Okay, this looks like this before the process, after the process. At least something you will get now. You explore the process, explore the papers, research papers, and give them the links. Don't give them, if you will give the research paper to the UGC student, it is futile. You will have to pinpoint, highlight the thing. This is the process. Look, this is the modification. Highlight that thing and give to your students. By this way, you can adapt the thing. And for the practical purpose, if you want to, for the assessment part, what I suggest you, that give them some practical exercises which are related to the calculations, maybe, which are related to the presentation of a particular exercise. These exercises can be online. The presentation may be online in Google Meet or whatever the platform you take. And you can have a more than a viva voce of those practical things. What will you do? So whatever the practical viva you take, you can assess that thing in the way. So you can take the submission of presentation or the, you know, short dissertation sort of thing, coupled with some quiz, practical quiz, which you will offer. Don't give much time. Just give 15 minutes for 30 questions, 15 minutes for 50 questions, and time bound. in Google Classroom, you can put, or in Microsoft Teams, you can put the time bar there that, okay, this set of questions are to be finished in this particular time. And by this way, you can do, I think. However, there is no thumb rule. Whatever you feel comfortable in and your students feel comfortable in, you should practice that thing. It is not like that I am an expert, I have told this, so this should be like this. No, it is your demand of student, your limitations, your resource availability, all things depend on these entire, you know, entire facts. Yeah.
Okay, sir, the next question is, since now that we are going in for online teaching in this era of pandemic, can you suggest some ways in which we can creatively engage students in an online class?
Yes, of course. As I've told in my presentation, that not only you have to learn developing the OERs, but also you will have to teach your student to develop small open educational resources. Don't get confused with this terminology OER. It is nothing like that. Whatever you like, that you have given the exercise, that I need the diagram, that diagram, you draw it in the 5 different pages and show me. They will just draw them, scan them, and get back to you. Make it in Google Classroom. Okay, simple things you adopt. Don't go, make it easy. If you complicate the things, it will be very problematic figure for you. So what you can do, depending on the available resources only, go for the online teaching and make it easy. This is my, again and again, I'm uttering it out, but to be very frank and to be very honest, it is the demand. You cannot overburden the student. If you overburden the student will run away.
Correct, yeah. Can I take the next question, sir?
Yeah, please.
There's a question. How can we teach those students who do not have smartphones and laptops? Many of the students in India are not able to attend classes because of the age.
Of course, this is a problem. So what we are catering? Swayamprabha. Swayamprabha is a channel. So it's a set of 32 video channels. Okay? And it is available in the free DTH. DD का फ्री डी टी एच आता है ना, उसमें वो फ्री है. तो वट यू शुड टेल देम दैट एंड इवन इन नाउ इट हैज ऑल्सो बीन ब्रॉडकास्टिंग, द ब्रॉडकास्टिंग हैज बीन स्टार्टेड इन द प्राइवेट डी टी एच चैनल ऑल्सो, आई थिंक इन दैट एयरटेल एंड टाटा स्काई, इट हैज ऑल्सो स्टार्टेड स्ट्रीमिंग दैट. हाउ 2-3 चैनल्स ओनली आर कमिंग आउट ऑफ 32 चैनल्स. तो एंड वट यू कैन डू दैट इन द university setup, maintaining the social distancing, first step you should take to install the DTH learning lab. Just you need to install that 2500 rupees DTH of free DTH, DT ka wo DTH lagana hai, and so that they can have, and you can have your own repository and you can submit them. Especially in the lockdown situation, yes, it is a problematic figure, even in the urban areas also. This is not just the problem of rural areas. Many areas are still untouched. In spite of our best efforts, we could reach only up to 40-50% of the students of our enrolled bona fide students. It is a problem, and we will have to explore the way out depending upon the things. So what I think that you can just, even if the, because smartphone is utmost important criteria for going for the online teaching. Without this, we cannot imagine. Everything will go in vain. So everything is hypothesized on the basis that every person is having the smartphone, at least. Even if it is not, he or she is having the laptop or PC, if he's having the that phone, smartphone, it can work. But my solution is that at the village level, the government should, at the panchayat level, the government should come up that in the Panchayat Bhavan, a free DTH is available there always, at least for learning and reaching to the education. And I think I have written, and in the Uttarakhand government especially, I am thankful to the Higher Education Department and the Honorable Minister Sri Dhan Singh Rawatji, that in the nook and corners of each and every government PG colleges, they have established the e-learning labs. It doesn't take nothing. E-learning lab is a huge word, but what things are required? 2,500 rupees DTH channel, free DTH, one-time investment, and 30-40 rupees, 1,000 rupees smart TV. That because we are taking in advance that when the connectivity will be good, it can be run live. So it will be connected. So it will also be used for the video conferencing and all that, and the DTH and the student can see the telecasted thing. And all the expert lectures delivered in the Swayamprabha can be given to the institutes, the students. And if this thing come into the if it is brought into the village level at the panchayat level, it would be boon for our Indian scenario. And this is going to happen, don't worry.
Okay, sir, thank you. The next question is, can you suggest a course or website where we can systematically learn all the things touched upon by you over a sustained period of time in order to become proficient in online teaching?
Don't worry, I'm coming up with a course. However, I think it would be on a paid platform. But for the technical aspect, all the technical aspect and simple things to acquaint you the knowledge, I'm also coming up with the things. However, you can get the things. Lot many things are there. You will get the platform. But I'm trying to bundle it in a course form, and soon we are going to come up. I will let you know. I will keep you posted within, I think, 1 week or 2 weeks maybe. With the maximum 2 weeks maybe, at least. I'm going to come up with that thing. Trying with it.
Next question is from Ms. Rashmi Bharati. How can we become a Swayam mentor? Is it possible to become a Swayam mentor?
Yeah. Swayam mentor is nothing. Swayam mentor is actually, you are the, mentor of your class. Why? Because the learners, you are also a learner, your student is also a learner. So if you are enrolled in my class, say for example, you are my academic writing course is there in your pre-PhD course. Many of universities have adopted our paper, academic writing, at their pre-PhD course or in PG courses also. Especially the BITS, Pilani, Mesra is giving the 4 credits for our course, for PG dissertation as an elective course. So what if a teacher is there, say for example, you are a teacher there, and your academic writing course has been passed by your BS for credit transfer. So you, along with your student, will get enrolled. You will get enrolled yourself and your student to the in the course. And whatever you learn there, you will make them easy for your students depending on their need. Might be in some reason there is a problem of language. Then at least you will be able to translate those things or that approach which your student need. So you will help them. And how you can do it? You can write to your SPOC, single point of contact, of Swayam coordinator. Swayam coordinator of a university. And if it is not there, please ask your institute to open up as a local chapter or a Swayam coordinator. Appoint the Swayam coordinator, like in HNB Gadwal Institute, I am the SPOC, I am the university Swayam coordinator. So what we can do, that if a particular entire class is taking up a particular course along with the teacher will be marked as a mentor by the SPOC, that SPOC or the single point of contact or whatever you call Swayam coordinator. And it will be intimated to the course coordinator of that particular course. So they will be having a position as a mentor. They will be marked as a mentor in the course, as I have shown you in my course also, that we have declared the thing, especially in the core courses like industrial pharmacy. We are running the single pharmacy MOOC, first pharmacy MOOC of the Swayam MOOC. So whoever the teacher is who is teaching that particular course along with their students, if they get registered, they will be recognized as a mentor, and respective points are there in their CS for being the Swayam mentor. Yeah.
Okay, sir. The next question is, is there any open university that gives credit-based learning?
there are so, you know, there is no IGNU is open university. Simply, I am proud to be an IGNU personnel. I have done my MBA with my job from IGNU, from MBA, and IGNU has inculcated all these concepts actually. Okay, whatever you are seeing at this particular time is the demand of the era. And apart from IGNU, so many universities are also here, but only as far as in the national scenario is concerned, I don't think so. The online certification has been allowed to any Indian university so far. They are claiming with in collaboration. Some universities are claiming in collaboration with the international scenario. I think this is to be legally checked. However, I think I've told you that 100 universities are coming up with the online degree programs. But SWAM itself gives the credits. If you go enroll in your particular subject, if you are studying a zoology and a particular subject of zoology is there in your syllabus, and this is mentioned in the SWAM guidelines that no university can deny the credit transfer earned through the MOOCs. It means if a student has earned a particular earned credit means qualified that particular course after the successful examination and he has got a certificate from MOOC, and if it matches with that particular syllabi, then university has to give the MOOCs the number of credits assigned for that. Okay, so it's better that universities, institutions, private universities, deemed universities explore subject-wise, faculty-wise courses from SWAM platform and adapt them, offer to your students, and it will make your life easy. Okay, please do that. And you, if you are running MBA, you and your student can learn the management principles from the IIM Bangalore. There are 19 courses, I think, from the IIM Bangalore in this cycle. They are going to run wonderful courses by the experts. You will be amazed to hear them. I've been trained in the IIM Bangalore and interacted many professors there. They are amazing. So sitting at any corner of India, you can learn from the experts. So don't be local. Be global. Be global in learning. Okay.
Okay, sir. The next question is, how can I take open-ended questions in online assignments?
This is the problem. Actually, open-ended questions are the toughest thing. You will have to be very smart in assessing profile. If you will give the open-ended question, you will have to check it manually. And this is very typical. You can keep it for PGs, but I don't recommend it for UG, especially when you are having a class of 1,000 or 2,000 students. It happens in government university. I think the many people who are here from government university, they know that what is the strength of their classes. So don't expect, don't do this kind of thing, open-ended questions. You will have to do it manually. You can't do anything. What you can do, you can make a team along with your colleagues or along with your research scholars and then assess them maybe. But not recommended for the UGs. What you can do, you give assessment smartly. You give, say for example, we have given the academic writing subject assignment is there, subject assignment. Other things are auto-graded. Weekly quiz are auto-graded. We have given the MCQs, like in Google form sort of thing, you can say. It is a different platform aware. And it is auto-graded, okay. But subject assignment, what we have done, we have given a task of completing that course and submit that course certificate. So assessment, they have learned it subjective. It is was subjective learning, but the outcome was objective. I think you are getting me. I just interested in seeing that certificate. If I saw that, oh, the certificate is uploaded, it means they have done the course. Okay. So, and I can cross check them with the authorities. So select this kind of strategies and plan this kind of strategy, which are, you know, auto graded, even for subjective things or open ended things. Got my point?
Yes, that's correct. Okay, sir, there's another question. Do we need to get any permission from the institution that we are working for providing lecture through online mode?
No, not at all. Not at all. You can teach any person. I think you don't require any permission for publishing your book. Do you require? No. As per the Intellectual Property Rights Act, IPR, the intellectual property generated through your, you know, intellectual, say for example, if it is specially for the teaching and learning, you can commercialize it without any permission even. In most of the, if you go for the IPR policy, you are at least for this thing, you are free. Okay, you can teach anyone, you can develop anything for teaching learning specifically. However, I am not saying that you can start your own industry and start yourself, you know, selling the things physically. It is about developing that online material or taking the online classes. No permission is required. Okay.
Okay, so there's a question from Ms. Amulya Venice. How can we make sure that the subject will reach below average students while doing online teaching? So how far do you think online teaching is suggestible?
One thing, what I told you, engagement is very important. What I told you is the engagement. Engagement is very important. That, okay, close it. Close it. Engagement is very important. You know, engagement is very, very important in online classes, what I told you. That if you say that you want to reach to diverse learners, first of all, online teaching should be planned in such a way. I told you to organize the thing. I told you to engage your students. You will have to plan a strategy for every kind of learner. If you go to the academic writing course, in my example, if I give example of my course itself, it has been planned for diverse learners, not only for the advanced learner, but also for the PG. Because we cannot cater in online teaching to at a time for a same pace for every kind of learner. You need to blend the contents which is required by the diverse kind of learners. You cannot skip the most very basic things, or you cannot say that, okay, you might be learning this thing. You will have to give a slight background always when you are teaching online. You can't expect that, even if I'm saying that this is the application of Bernoulli's theorem, you will have to at least give what was the Bernoulli theorem, in brief at least. So background you will have to give. So catering the diverse learner, average learners, it is at most important. I think that the average or below average students can avail the benefit if you give them little attention. Little attention means I couldn't get your comment on that particular point. What happened? You can poke the discussion in the discussion forum from that particular student. Okay, if you know them, and or you can have a. You can open up a question which is actually meant for the kind of learner. Okay, you can mute or you can address the question to particular kind of particular learners to increase their engagement, to encourage them to, and they feel free in the online platform to raise your queries. Physically, most of the time they hesitate. They are afraid of you, but in online they are free. Also. Yeah, please. I think you might have got my point.
Okay, sir. The next question is, how do you think students can be encouraged to enroll for Swayam or MOOC courses?
Yes, this is the thing why I'm here. We are the Swayam ambassadors. Actually, first of all, teachers must explore the things fully. When you will come to learn, when you will come to know about the Swayam, please, please transact that thing to your students. Okay. And Swayam has got wonderful platform and very easy to enroll. Say, for example, for 1 minute, I will just take you to that platform just to show the live view. Okay. Just presenting it for 1 minute only. Okay. Yes, this is the platform. Say, for example, this is our academic writing course. Okay, what you need to do, say, for example, aap Swayam pe gaye, you went to the Swayam. I'm taking it to the back. Okay, is a SWAMS website, and whatever the ICT initiative MHRD I have told you is there. And before I may forget that, so I'm taking you to my university's website, which is having a wonderful repository. Okay, swamshnbgu.in. If you type, we have just prepared this. It is not core university's website. It is a website developed by the SWAM cell. So swamshnbgu.in. ICT initiatives are given there. The links are visible. You can just click them and you will get all the links here. These are the list also for the credit transfer things, and the regulations are also there. You can go ahead. Okay. These are the information about the two courses, and this click repository. Can you see it? Repository. So why I'm telling you that being a teacher, you can make your own repository of your institution. Okay. Repository mein karne ka kya hai? What you need to do? You need to have a compilation of the created open educational resources. Say, for example, you have prepared a slide, uploaded to the SlideShare or the YouTube. Just share the link to this platform. Okay, now this is the platform. Can you see? We can filter it here with the subjects. It is loading. Just hold on. And the date range. This is okay. Can you see this? This is not just this thing. Can you see the numbers? 1803 is the figure. Self-created are 322. Self-suggested are 1481. Biochemistry, biotechnology, zoology, the different subject coverage are there. And all the topics are related specifically to our syllabus. Syllabus oriented. You can create your own repository. Departmental, subject-wise, institutional. It's your choice. So we at the Gadwal University have taken this initiative to create this a platform. Even you upload some notes to your own drive and give the link. Many people have shared the drive link here. Okay, simple drive link. Our message is to reach to a student. Now, going to the SWAM. Now you want to, you can search the courses. Either you go to the all courses. Simply all courses, you will get the list of all the courses. Okay? Agar aapko dekhne ka hai ki kaun sa course karna hai, if you know the name, they say, for example, this is the list of this semester and it is just increasing day by day because it's opening. They say, for example, you go for the academic writing. This is our course portal. This is my course. Okay? One of the course, in the other course is industrial pharmacy. You go to the portal, click it here. Sign in, click sign in, okay, click sign in, and by the Google, you just mention your student that how it is done. Click from Google, forget about this thing. You go to either from Google or from Microsoft or Facebook, you can log in. Say, for example, from Google, I'm going and I'm getting enrolled with any website. Say, for example, Open Knowledge. I think I'm already maybe a learner for this. Yeah, this I got registered. So go to my courses, and from single ID, you don't need different IDs. You can have enrollment in more than 30, 50, any number you can enroll. So you just enroll the courses. Say, for example, from this ID, I have learned from these courses, academic writing, in this course, I can go to the course. And that's the same portion is there, what I showed you. No, this is the I have shared with my learners. This is the running course which we have completed. No, this is the thing. And if you enroll at this moment, you won't see this course outline in this thing because it is released weekly. So whatever is available to you at this particular week will be available because it is the last cycle's portal. So you are seeing it all the things. So these are the, let's say, for example, plagiarism. So you will get the plagiarism week 3 intro video. You will click. So these windows are opened. Okay. You can, this is the, Dr. Mona Simultis plagiarism lectures. So in this way, you can explore. Please explore and just enrollment, you must know. You can, by click, you can explore the things. And I welcome you in my course in academic writing. This is one of the most wonderful course which we have bundled for you. We are proud that we have triggered a lot many academic writers with the huge number of publications. this is the course for the industry of pharmacy, which we have. I'm not going to detail. And coming back to the to your answering the thing. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I think we can take one last question.
Yes, please.
Okay, sir. There's my last question for you. It is like, how far do you think doing courses online is beneficial in comparison to the regular courses when we look at the value-added aspects?
I will give you some examples. I'm not saying that without teacher's invention, anything can be done. Teacher's role is always there. Okay. As a blender, as a blenderer, or for blended learning, flipped learning. And online learning has got many advantages. Limitations are always there. Speed, connectivity, you know, so many issues. You know the issues. So we will start numbering the things. You can count a lot many things. But apart from conventional, what are the advantages? Number one, these are the only solution to complete a syllabi, especially in the credit-based system, semester system, to complete it fully. Have you completed 100% of your syllabus in any semester? No, you can't. Many times you skip one unit base or one particular topic, or you do it yourself. In online, you will complete it 100%, number one. Number two, power pack presentation will be there. Students will get ready notes. Have you given the notes of each and every topic physically when you are taking the class? No. It is neither possible or nor you people do, nor we people do. But in online learning, we give, especially in the MOOCs I'm talking about, we give each and every transcript, the notes are given there. Okay, they can read, you can download the things, you can see lot many times. Physical teaching mein kya hota hai? What happens, teacher comes in, delivers the lecture and goes out. Vivid Bharati ki tarah one time broadcasting hona hai. ठीक है, but in MOOCs you can keep on rewinding the things, keep on playing the things again and again until you understand the things. These are the beauties, you know. There's always pros and cons. If you want to be the part of solution, see the positive thing, and if you want to, I won't comment. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much. So I invite Professor Abhinash John Peter, IQAC Assistant Coordinator, to propose a vote of thanks.
Thank you very much, Nisha ma'am. Our RP for the day, Dr. Ajay Simalti, Dr. Nisha Tomji Varghese, Dean of the IQAC, St. Abel's College, Ernakulam, and all the participants who are viewing the webinar through Google Meet as well as our YouTube Live. All of us in the teaching profession are wondering how to tackle the problem that we are facing today, how to change, how to adapt to the new situation of teaching and learning. So the session that we've had, I believe, was very fruitful to you all. Dr. Ajay Simalti explained to us how to adapt to the situation, how to tackle the issue of shifting our education, how to shift the teaching practices from offline to online mode. I believe that all of us here have had a very fruitful session, and on behalf of IQAC St. Albert's College, Ernakulam, on behalf of everyone who is watching through our YouTube platform and Google Meet platform, I extend you, sir, our sincere gratitude.
One thing I want to add. I want to extend my special thanks to one of my learner, jinki wajah se main aapke saath juda hoon, Appu Jacob John, isn't it? Thank
yes.
you,
yes,
Appu. Thanks a lot. Okay.
Okay. So, I was going to mention that because it's Dr. Appu is my close friend. He's the one who introduced me to Dr. Ajay Samalti, and it has been a kind of very nice collaboration with you, sir. Especially thank yesterday you. When such heaters happened also. Thank you so much for the support and your kindness. You know, you were kind of very supportive, and thank you so much. And thank you, Abhinash, for the warm words of thanks also. I want to take this opportunity to thank all the respected teaching faculty and those students and research scholars who have taken time out and have joined this webinar. I'm sure it has been very, very informative. I've been able to learn a lot of new things, and definitely, as sir said, I would love to join for your academic writing course. And so thank you so much. Let me just remind you a few things. The feedback link has been posted both in the chat box of the YouTube and also here. And the video will be posted. The recorded video will be posted in the college YouTube channel. We can also give you the link if you want it. And so please don't forget to fill in the feedback link. Thank you so much, Ajay sir. Thank you so much for taking this opportunity. Dhanyavaad.
Happy learning.